She's a young British officer in the ambassador. Grace, we'll receive grace. finally these traitors has betrayed the Palestinian people, stood with Israel, are supporting this genocide, this massacre, and they are funding them and giving them weapons, unfortunately. But forget them, the Ummah is with you, Allah is with you, and inshallah ta'ala you will be victorious very, very soon, inshallah ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you. We need it to be filled with hundreds of thousands of pictures with people in their thousands and their millions in cities across the globe standing shoulder to shoulder in solidarity with Palestine. We must demand a ceasefire. We must demand access to aid, food, water and power. We must demand an end to the blockade. Demand that Israel ends the decades of occupation and system of apartheid, because that is the only way to ensure long-lasting peace. Free, free!
Palestine!
Free, free!
Palestine!
Free, free!
Palestine!
Pressure up. I can confirm that the Palestine Solidarity Campaign and our partners will be calling another march next Saturday. I need every single person here, that's all 150,000 of you, to go home to bring one friend or more to the Zeno next week. We need to see double, at least double, the amount of people next week. We need to show the British government, we need to show the architects of Israeli apartheid that we are not going anywhere. We will never stop fighting until every Palestinian is free to return to their home. Now, the next of our last four speakers is another member of the Labour movement. Please give a warm welcome to the founder and chair of Labour in Palestine, Hugh Manning.
Thank you so much for being here. I was at the Liverpool conference, the Labour Party, and I wish you'd all been there. There was so much intimidation going on. People being told not to speak out on Palestine, trying to cancel meetings. Labour Party members should be here, not supporting war crimes by Israel. Saturday, Netanyahu said he was declaring war on Palestine. Israel declared war on Palestine in 1948. Israel declared war on Palestine in 1967. Israel declared war on Palestine with every settlement, with a siege, with a wall, and every one of those is a breach of international law. International law is not a pick and mix. You can't choose. If you're on the side of international law, Israel must be held to account when it breaches international law. Our organization should not travel from the river to the sea. Thank you.
best way to the upper end?
Sorry?
What's the best way to the upper end?
Round
left. Thank you very much. Sorry, my friend.
Let's go! love it, people love it.
You're so good, man.
What are these ones about, Chris?
Huh?
What are these ones about?
I don't know, this is one that I think this is going to go with. Because there's an Israeli fucking store right there with the old village on the right hand side.
Oh, is that what it was?
Yeah, they've already got a few confrontations.
Yes. Thank you. Yeah. Free! Run, two, three, four!
TV, mate. You can't read it.
Palestine will be free.
One, two, three, four!
no more!
I want to press charges.
No, I do that.